Good morning, Mount Calvary. It's a great day to be in the house of the Lord. I'm telling you, this is a brand new day. It's not just another day, it's a brand new day. And I want to welcome everyone to our 10 o'clock service. I don't think we have any visitors, but if I miss anybody, welcome. You're always welcome in the house of the Lord. And while I'm here doing the welcome and the prayer, I just want to thank everyone. It's been a long time, 15 months, since I've seen most of you. But I've heard from you on phone calls, text messages, Facebook posted on the passing of my mother and father. And I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you, and I appreciate it. And continue to pray for our family. We're still struggling, but the Lord is lifting us up. And he won't put any more on us than we can bear. And I'm a witness to that now. Okay, so let us pray. Father God, we come with thanksgiving on our heart. And Father God, we just thank you for the many blessings that you just bestowed on Mount Calvary down through the years. And Father God, I just want to thank you for our ministers and our leaders. And Father God, I just ask that you just continue to strengthen them in their endeavors, Father God, that we'll be able to be that beacon of light to others. Father God, I just ask that you continue to strengthen and bless our members. Father God, we need you. Father God, we are all standing in the need of prayer. And Father God, you told and left on record that we can look to the hills for which come our help. And Father God, I'm telling you right now, we are looking. And Father God, I just ask that you can come in the presence in the midst of this service today. And Father God, I just ask that you open up our hearts and our minds, Father God, that we'll be able to receive your word and be able to love one another and teach us to love one another as you have loved us. Father God, teach us how to have joy. Teach us how to have peace, Father God. And Father God, I just ask that you continue to strengthen us in every way that you can possibly imagine. Now, Father God, I want to thank you for my family. I want to thank you for the things that you've done for my family. And Father God, I want you to use me in the manner in which you see fit. And Father God, I just pray that you teach me how to pray. And Father God, teach me what I need to be praying for. And Father God, I just thank you for all the things that you've done and all of the things that you're about to do. Now, Father God, I just ask that we all open up our hearts and our minds and receive the message that's going to be left on record for us. Then we'll be able to go out and share that good news about you to someone that don't know you. And Father God, this is my prayer this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Yeah. better than good. And he is way more than enough. Amen. 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 When we look at what God has done in our lives, we ought to just say thank you and praise his name. He has been better than good and way more than enough. We want to thank Brother Terry for doing our greeting and prayer this morning. We are mindful. We want to give everyone an opportunity to take part in our worship service, and he did what he was asked to do, and we want to encourage anyone who feel like praying for your services, feel free to say, I want to pray today. Amen. 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 Let us pray. Dear Father, we come now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we love you. Lord, we magnify you. Lord, you have been better than good and way more than enough. Lord, you have kept us from danger seen and unseen. And Lord, we have come through sickness. And Lord, some have walked behind the hearse. And Lord, through it all, you sustained us. And you lift us up. And Lord, we ask you now to decrease me where you may be increased. Where there may be more of you, less of me. Lord, that your word fall upon ears that will hear. That through your word you may be edified, glorified, and magnified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our scripture in Luke, the 17th chapter, verses 11 through 19. Luke chapter 17. Verses 11 through 19, and it reads, It happened that as he made his way through Jerusalem, he crossed over the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 men, all lepers, met him. They kept their distance, but raised their voices, calling out, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. Taking a look at them, he said, go, show yourself to the priests. They went, and while still on their way, became clean. One of them, when he realized that he was healed, turned around and came back shouting his gratitude, glorifying God. He kneeled at Jesus' feet, so grateful. He couldn't thank him enough. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said, were not 10 healed? Where are the 9? Can none be found to come back and give glory to God except this outsider? Then he said to him, get up, on your way. Your faith has healed and saved you. We'd like to use for our subject this morning, I can't thank him enough. I can't thank him enough. I tell people everywhere I go that I'm thankful that the Lord allowed my mother and grandmother to live long enough to instill some of the things that they were taught into our spirits. And one of the things that they taught me was that your manners will take you further or farther than your money. I believe we forgot that. I believe if we really look back over our lives, we could come to the conclusion that where we are didn't come from what we had. It came from being mindful how to treat others in the right way, being appreciative for the things the Lord have blessed you with. They taught us to say thank you. They gave us an attitude of gratitude. They reminded us, can you speak when you walk into a place and you see somebody? And I don't know how other folk were raised, but I struggle not to speak to folk. Sometimes Carrie said, Papa, you know them? I said, no, but you're just supposed to be nice to people. I just speak. Me and Walmart's my parents, how you doing? Papa, you know them? But some folk can walk by and on purpose. I don't know you. Well, I done spoke to you. You speak, I ain't speaking to you. I ain't got time for all that. You got to release that love on the inside of you, because you never know who's behind you looking to see some light in this world full of darkness. Yes, people can find ways to cuss and fuss, complain, but they struggle to say two words that would get you across the finish line. Thank you. Can you just say thank you? Is it difficult just to say thank you? You can be taken advantage of, get your feelings hurt, but when someone says thank you, all those bad feelings seem to just go out the door. When you grow physically and spiritually, if you don't learn how to express your thankfulness to God, you're going to be immature in your Christian walk. You have food in the refrigerator, clothes on your back, roof over your head, and a place to sleep. You ought to wake up every day. I don't care what anybody said about you. I don't care how many times somebody hurt your feelings. When you get up in the morning, in your own place, what God has given you, you ought to wake up and say, how many this morning? I ain't talking about just saying thank you, but how many this morning got up out of their bed with what went on all through the night? You heard the wind blow and the storm rise. How many got up and just said, Lord, I thank you? Can you find three reasons this morning to tell God thank you? Money in the bank, a few dollars in your pocket, little spare change in your car. You ought to say thank you. If you woke up this morning feeling better than you did yesterday, you ought to say thank you. If your family's doing well, say thank you. If your neighbors and neighbor children doing well, you ought to say thank you. Your brother and sister doing all right, you ought to say thank you. But I'm mindful that everybody don't react the same way. Some folk are grateful, and some folk are not grateful. I heard James Cleveland say some folk can complain about being hungry with a loaf of bread under their arm. But if you know God, if God really did something in your life, and we say it this way, when you know that you know that you know that God has been good to you, you ought to be so grateful to just say thank you because I'm alive. Thank you because you brought me through another day. Thank you. Because nobody can do me like Jesus, thank you. Because you're worthy to be praised. I shared with you many years ago, Deacon Mitchell was praying, and I was in the pulpit with Reverend Harris, and Deacon Mitchell began to pray, and I love to tell the story because I like his spirit when he prayed. And he was praying, he said, Lord, I thank you that when I come through the light, that it had a green light, it had a yellow light, it had a red light, and Lord, then it had a light with an arrow on it that let me know to go left or right. And Lord, I thank you that I knew the difference. Then he kept on praying and thanking God. And when he got to a point of his prayer, he was so thankful, he just simply said, Lord, I thank you that I can thank you. That you miss your shout. You ought to be thankful that you can just say thank you. In this text, we see Jesus traveling, the Bible says, along the border of Samaria and Galilee, and 10 lepers, 10 men, shows up. These men have left their home. They had to join a, had to join a new club called the Lepers Club. They couldn't live in their homes anymore. Didn't have job. They shut off from family, shut off from friends, shut off from the house of the Lord because they were lepers. They couldn't even go and worship. They were incurably sick and needed to be touched by the hands of God. And the Bible says that they knew where the doctors had failed. They knew what the dermatologist said. Salve wasn't going to work. But they knew that God never failed. They knew that God's voice could open ears and fix tissues of skin and make them whole again just at his word. And they knew that they just put their trust in, if they just call on Jesus, that there was hope. Don't you know that no matter what you're going through, because you can call on Jesus, you still have some hope. You still have some hope. Oh, you can clap on that. You still have some hope. No matter where you are in life right now, no matter what you may be struggling with, if you call on Jesus, you'll find hope. And these men, because of what they had gone through, teaches us a lesson on being thankful. Shouldn't have to wait till Thanksgiving to be concentrated on being thankful. Just like we shouldn't have to wait on Easter to celebrate how Jesus died for our sins. And one of the things that I see in this text is sometimes you have to go by yourself. When you have a thankful heart, sometimes you have to go by yourself. The Bible says one of them, when he realized that he was healed, turned around and came back shouting his gratitude, glorifying God. If you're going to be truly thankful, if you're going to really give God his praise, and you find yourself struggling doing it, you might need to drop some folk. You might need to unfriend some folk. You might need to take some folk off your Twitter. You might need to quit messaging everybody. Every now and then, when you have a thankful spirit, When you want to give God all you got, every now and then you're going to have to find yourself hanging out with a new crowd. You got to hang out with other folk who's heading where you are going. One of the things my mother taught us, no matter who I told her I was friend with, she taught me hanging with, she never talked about somebody else's child. She never said, Kenny, that boy is bad and you don't need to be hanging around that boy. She made it simple. She said, Kenny, you show me your friends, I'll show you your faults. I didn't understand it then. But what she was saying is, if you hang around folk that's hateful and you're kind, when you see them being hateful to folk and don't chastise them, then you are telling them it's all right to be hateful. If you're around folk who want to cause problems and you want peace, you're telling those folk you're hanging around, you endorse his problems. So I found myself being by myself. I found myself trying to be around folk that was going where I was going. And you know where I found myself at? Most of our old people. All my life, I found myself, the best man in my wedding was Deacon M. Harden. Old enough to be my granddaddy. I hung around the older people because, number one, I wasn't jealous of them. And number two, they weren't jealous of me. They had already accomplished everything they were going to accomplish. So all they could do for me, those that just give me guidance, tell me the good things about life, what not to do, talk about their experience, how God had blessed them. Every now and then, you got to get away from folk. That doesn't mean you any good. When was the last time you talked to somebody about God? When was the last time somebody came to you with some foolishness? And instead of you listening to the foolishness, you told them, you know what? God will make a way out of no way. We got to be mindful that when you have a thankful heart, you have to separate yourself. There's a whole lot of people. They have a lot of stuff. And I tell folk all the time, you can't impress me with stuff. You got to be mindful. You got to be around people that just love folk. It's not about what you got. I like to be around people that love folk, like to do nice things for folk. You hang around folk that like to do what God says do. And when you do that, you'll find yourself going to God by yourself. The Bible says that 10 shouted Jesus' name. Jesus healed 10. They walked away healed, but only one, he came back by himself. Sometime you may be the only one in your row to wave your hand in praise. Sometime you may be the only one to say amen to the preacher's preaching. Sometime you'll be the only one to give the choir an amen for their singing. You may be the only one. And when you do, sometimes folks just look at you funny. Can I give you this for free? There's not one person in here this morning that God hadn't blessed. There's not one person in this place this morning that God haven't blessed. And if God has blessed you, wave your hand. I rest my case. Some struggle even to show outwardly that God has blessed you. God wants a thank you. Yes, some folk will stop you. You got to be ever so mindful that you can't get to Jesus on a group plan. Can't get to him on a group plan. You can't let mama's relationship say Jesus got you. My mama pray. My dad pray. You can't get with Jesus on a group plan. You have to know him for yourself. I'm glad my mama prayed for me. I'm glad she taught me some stuff. But I learned what I know now. I'm talking about what I know in my lifetime. I've seen how good God been to me and my family. I think about it. I just have to say thank you. And when you recognize that Jesus did it all for you, then you can say thank you. Don't worry about a crowd. Don't worry about how many people are following you. You just thank God for yourself. Don't worry about who he blessed around you. You thank God for what he done for you. He woke you up this morning. He started you on your way. And when you think about it that way, you can just say, thank you. And the second thing we see here is, when you have a thankful heart, you don't care who's watching you. When you have a thankful heart, you don't care who's watching you. Verse 16 says, he kneeled at Jesus' feet, so grateful he couldn't thank him enough. And he was a Samaritan. This leper fell on his face at the feet of Jesus and gave him thanks, even though Jesus was a Jew and he was an outside child. Can I get you some free? It doesn't matter to God where you come from. It doesn't matter to God what side of town you are from. It doesn't matter to God what your family tree may be like. All that matters to him is that you are grateful that he brought you from danger seen and unseen. He praised God or Jesus for what Jesus had done for him. He didn't care who, he didn't do this privately. He came by himself. But when he began to thank Jesus, he did this openly. He didn't care who was watching him. The Bible says he was so grateful, he couldn't thank Jesus enough. He fell down at Jesus' feet, thanking him for his healing. He didn't care who was looking at him. How many times you've been in a situation, in a setting where everybody's supposed to be saved, everybody's supposed to be Christ-like, and you start crying and folk look at you and wonder what you're crying about. Every now and then, you ought to cry just because the Lord has done something for you. Carrie was saying one time in the car, and when we got home, and she said, Paul, put that song back on. And she got on YouTube and started singing that song again. And tears just came out of my eyes. I said, Papa, why are you crying? I said, Carrie, Papa will cry sometime. Sometime, something ought to move you. Because God has done something for you. You don't care who see you crying. You don't care who see you waving your hand. You don't care who see you shout and say amen. Folk are afraid to shout nowadays because they're scared folks think they're crazy. But every now and then, you ought to have a crazy shout on you. Y'all be crazy enough to let the world know that God has been mighty good to you. It don't bother me when I give God his due. God done more for me than anybody with two legs, two arms, two eyes, two feet could ever do for me. I got to praise him. I got to thank him. I got to give him all I got. I can't thank him enough. Yes. we got to be mindful. Some folk beg him, Lord, bless my aching feet. Bless my aching arms. Bless this, and Lord, bless that. You call on him to do things for you. And then you even pray, Lord, I'm glad that my bed I slept on wasn't my cooling board. But he woke you up, not on a cooling board, and you can't say thank you in public. Can I give this for free? One of the tricks of Satan is to make you so petty and so important and so busy and so troubled that you won't worship him openly. It's more than just coming, sitting down, hearing a message and hearing a song and going home. He requires our worship. He requires a thank you. We come here to say, Lord, thank you. Yes, he wants to get you to the next step, to where you need to be with him. Not only when you have a thankful heart, you have to be by yourself sometime. You don't care what folk think of what folk watching you. But the third thing I see, when you have a thankful heart, you receive more from Jesus. You just miss your shout. When you have a thankful heart, the third thing, you will receive more from Jesus. Verse 19 says, then he said to him, get up on your way. Your faith has healed you and saved you. You just missed your shot. He said, get up on your way. Your faith has healed you and save you. The King James translation said, thy faith have made thee whole. There was 10 lepers. One was a stranger. You can talk about what may happen to the other 9. Don't worry too much about that. You need to look at, where are you? Which one are you? I ain't worried about the, were there not 10? Jesus, in this text, was looking for a thank you. Ain't that something? Of all the people, Jesus was looking for a thank you. I know what he said. There's been time in the Bible. Jesus tells somebody, he told a leper, one leper, he said, now, I'm going to heal you, but you tell nobody. You go on. I don't want people to be all over me. But when he was healed, he had excusable disobedience. He went ahead and told it anyhow. Bless all over the world. But this time, Jesus said, go show yourself to the priests. They did exactly what Jesus says. But I'm giving you for free. When Jesus blesses you and he heals you, just because he heals you doesn't mean your healing is over. 10 were healed. but one got saved. Don't you know that you can be healed and not saved? You can shout for your healing and still not be saved. There's been a lot of time folk get on their bed of affliction and say, Lord, if you just heal my body, when I get off my bed, Lord, you cure me, Lord. I'm going to be better for you. I'm going to do this for you. I'm going to do that for you. And as soon as God gets you on your feet, as soon as he brings you out of darkness, as soon as he fixes that situation, instead of going back outwardly and boldly, you're in the hospital. And you make this promise, Lord, get off my bed. And get in God's house. And don't say a word. You're healed, but you're not whole. Jesus said, nine was healed. Nine was given the gift of healing. But only one came back to thank the giver. 10 was given another chance, but only one came back and thanked him for the chance. And when he came back, Jesus said, now you are saved. He left being a Samaritan, came back a child of God. He left being an outside child, came back being adopted. He left being an outcast, came back, now he's in the club. When God bless you all over, you can't help but say thank you. And the Bible says, and I believe what that Samaritan did, I'm the same way. I'm like Gomer Powell. The Bible said, he said, I couldn't thank him enough. In other words, when he came to Jesus, he just kept saying, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Jesus didn't get tired of hearing that. Every now and then, y'all just said, Jesus, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Can anybody give him some thank you this morning? He said, thank you. You kept me. Thank you. You never left me. Thank you. You brought me. Thank you. You told me every day with Jesus. Every day with Jesus is better than before. Every day is a new day. Every day I got something to thank him for. Brand new. Thank him for. Yesterday ain't the same as today. Every day is a new day. If you can't think of anything else, y'all thank him for Calvary. Thank they died for your sin. Thank him they went up to Golgotha's hill. Thank him that they nailed his hand and ripped his feet. Thank him that they pierced him in the side. Thank him that he died for your sin. Thank him he didn't say day. Thank him early Sunday morning. He got all power in his hand. Thank him because he's Jesus. And if anybody here that know my Jesus, anybody here that know the Lord, won't he make a way for you? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? If he do it, say yes. Say yes. Oh, say yes. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. He's worthy to be praised. You ought to thank him. You ought to thank him for all the stuff that's going on in this world. All the stuff. More folk are concentrated on the Olympics than they are on thanking God. They're more concerned about a young lady who said, I got too much on me. I don't feel like turning flips. It'd be different. She wasn't turning flips before. But you saw the young lady. You know her ability. You know what she can do. But even that's why people have to be careful talking about the greatest of all time. There's nobody greater. Nobody. got to be careful who you set your eyes on. But look at God. He's keeping her. Nobody know what pressure somebody going through. That's why you got to be careful how you talk about folk. You got to be careful what you say around folk. You don't know what that person going through. You don't want no emotion that person going through. Be careful how you treat a woman whose child may be a little bit more rowdy than your child. You don't know what she went through that morning. You know how she struggled to do what she has to do for that child. It's easy all y'all to whip a child. Well, that may work for you, but it may not work for her. You know what child raised themselves up. But there is somebody that know all about it. And that's Jesus Christ. If you spend time with him, he'll work it out for you. If you recommend Jesus, he'll fix it for you. But you gotta thank him to get all of your blessings. If you don't know him, the hymn writer says, all you have to do is confess your mouth, believe in your heart. In Christ, you die for your sin, Paul said, and you shall be saved. Will you give yourself to him this morning? Will you give yourself away to him so he can use you? Will you give yourself to him so he can make you free? Will you give yourself to him so he can make a way out of no way? Just give yourself away. That's where it starts. Surrender means let it go. Let go of the mess. Let go of the confusion. The Bible said, take your cares to him. Let him have it. Suffered, bled, and died, reminded what he said at the cross, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And when you remember Calvary, remember what the blood means. When you go to Calvary, you know what the body have done. When you go to Calvary, you understand that God loved you so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him did not perish, but had everlasting life. Let us pray. Dear Father, we come now in the name of Jesus. Lord, be never so mindful that you suffered, bled, and died for our sins. And Lord, now, let us take the bread and the cup in the manner you said, and the Bible said that he took the bread, he blessed it, and he broke it, saying, this is my body that was broken for you. Take ye, eat all of it. Do this in remembrance of me. Says, in like manner, he took the cup. It may not look like much, but he said, this is my blood that was shed for the remission of sin of the New Testament. Drink ye all of it in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 We want to be mindful of all the parents. They got children. They want you to do a drive-through and pick up your gifts and things for the children after we dismiss. Before we dismiss, we want to pray. Our children's school has started. Our teachers, COVID don't allow us to join, hold hands, and come like we used to. But we do want you to stand if you're a school teacher, if you're educated, if you got children, grandchildren, stand, and we pray for our leaders in school, our teachers in school, our students in school, and those who are taking care of our children, Boys and Girls Club all over this city. Amen. Let us pray. Dear Father, we come now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we're mindful that this is the season where we're going back to our different schools. Lord, you've been blessing us down through the years. You've been keeping us. And Lord, even through this pandemic, Lord, you blessed our children to be safe last year. Lord, we thank you for that. Our teachers, our educators, Lord, you brought them through it. Lord, right now, Lord, as they try to get back to doing it the same old way, Lord, we ask you to bless those who are teaching our children. Let them walk in that classroom with a grateful heart, with a thankful spirit. For Lord, if the one who teaches the children aren't thankful, Lord, the children, Father, may feel they're not worthy. Lord, we ask you to let them teach, Lord, understanding hearts. Lord, we ask you to take our children, Lord, and protect them through it all. And Lord, we ask them, Father, that you let our children's mind be open to the newness. Lord, we know it was rough on them. Lord, some struggled, but Lord, you made a way. Some stumbled, but you made a way. And Lord, just protect them, Father, those bus drivers as they travel up and down the dangerous highways and streets and communities. Let them be mindful, Lord, to keep their eyes open, Lord, to watch every child be safe. And Lord, for all the parents, some who have some reservations about sending a child out, Lord, let them know, give them peace of mind that you are the God that's still able to take care of every situation. Yes, Lord, let them be of smile. Tell the children the safe things to do. Encourage them, Lord, to learn all they can learn. And Lord, when they learn all they can learn, Lord, let them never graduate from you. Let them, dear Father, learn about your will and your ways. While they're teaching everything else in school, Lord, let the parents teach them about how you went to Calvary. Let the parents teach them how you made a way out of no way. Let the parents let them know how to say, now lay me down to sleep. Pray the Lord my soul to keep. Lord, bless them, Lord. And Lord, we're going to be ever so mindful to give this year to you, Lord. No matter what happens, it's in your hands. And Lord, we're going to praise you in advance because you're able to do anything but fail. Now keep us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Consider yourself dismissed. Comrade.